Chinese government officials now installing fences in Shanghai, blocking people from leaving their homes for fear that they'll spread COVID. The panic is now spreading to Beijing, where authorities are testing nearly 20 million residents at least three times this week. David Culver, as you know, is part of the only American television crew living through the harsh lockdown in Shanghai, and he is once again out front.
It's the video Chinese censors do not want you to see or share. As it sparked a rare digital uprising on social media this weekend, highlighting a shared misery and helplessness felt across Shanghai. The video points to dysfunction, mismanagement, a city in chaos, struggling to cope with a surge in COVID cases. It resonates with so many of Shanghai's 25 million residents feeling trapped, turning to the most popular Chinese communication platforms, Weibo and WeChat, to vent. Amidst what is government-controlled internet, with any dissent quickly suppressed and erased, China's censors over the weekend struggled to keep up. No sooner would they block one version of the video did another resurface, rapidly multiplying, flooding China's cyberspace. Some versions even disguised as QR codes to throw off the censors. The online rattling of social stability was a growing rejection of China's harsh COVID containment measures. Some even sharing this clip from the 2012 movie Les Mis, referencing a 19th century uprising in Paris. The censors swiftly clamped down, extinguishing the spread. But the users also taking aim at the obvious censorship itself, sharing clips of their own officials proclaiming China's citizens have a right to freely express themselves. Seemingly ironic, given even the first line of China's own national anthem is now blocked online. The words, "Rise, those who don't want to be enslaved," now used as a veiled reference to criticize their own government. For some, Shanghai feels like the world's largest prison. CNN witnessing it firsthand.
The extent of my freedom is all the way to my terrace door here. We're lucky enough to at least get some fresh air outside. Our community volunteer is sending me this image of what's on the other side of our door, a freshly taped paper seal, a reminder not to leave.
And if I manage to get out, there's now a COVID guard posted day and night. Outside several apartment compounds, fences going up, neighbors sharing shocking images of new barriers on social media. Listen to them howl from their balconies as they're further caged in. Some finding workarounds, buying their groceries through the added layer. Others desperately rattling locks, hoping to escape. And then there are those who manage to tear down the walls. For folks locked into their homes, scenes like this are a terrifying reality. An apartment fire over the weekend in Shanghai's business district. State media quick to report that everyone got out safely. But it raises questions. Might these COVID barriers be more of a danger than the virus itself? And if you thought the city might be near reopening or easing lockdowns, images from the streets of Shanghai show giant containers, not bringing in much-needed supplies, but rather helping to build more blockades. This as more positive cases and close contacts are rounded up and sent to government quarantine facilities. Some left to sleep in tents in the middle of deserted streets, as their dormitories are disinfected. As the rising tune of discontent echoes throughout the eerily empty metropolis, for many, Shanghai has fallen.
And Aaron, you mentioned the outbreak now spreading in Beijing and the mass testing underway there. Well, the government within Beijing trying to reassure residents in the capital, saying, hey, don't worry, we've got plenty of supplies. But people there are still panic buying nonetheless. Many with this mentality of, hey, we saw what happened in Shanghai. We're not taking any chances.
Wow. Amazing. All right, David, thank you very much.